Android Oreo is here and available to consumers. Hopefully you've taken the opportunity to test and update your apps during the long preview process so those influential vocal early adopters have a great experience. Let's review what O brings, a chocolate sandwich cookie of important structural changes with sweet new capabilities. The most important stuff first. You should keep in mind that even if your app doesn't yet target O, it will behave differently on O in a few ways. When your app is in the background, i.e. without an active activity or foreground service, location updates will be significantly less frequent. When your app no longer has an active activity, service, or other component, any wake locks it holds will be automatically released. For devices that come with Google Play services, settings.secure.androidid will return a different value for each app based upon the signing key and user profile. For advertising, you really need to be using Google Play services' user-resettable advertising ID. Here's another privacy-related change. Apps targeting O won't be able to get access to user accounts using the Get Accounts permission. Instead, apps must rely on the account chooser activity. Account owners can now choose whether their accounts will be visible to other apps, and the account chooser activity will be updated accordingly. If you're targeting O, your app will have new limits on background processing. In summary, only a small number of broadcasts can be used to start your app, such as boot completed. Also, your app will no longer be able to start services when in the background. You'll need to rely on explicit broadcast receivers, jobs, Firebase Cloud Messaging, and Start Foreground, a new API to start foreground services. Android Oreo adds features to support wide gamut displays, including 16-bit PNG and ICC profiles in JPEG, PNG, and WebP, along with new utilities such as Color Space and Color Long. Android O also supports longer, narrower screens, and apps that target Android O no longer have a default maximum aspect ratio of 1.86. If your activity needs to set a maximum aspect ratio, the system will letterbox your app if you set resizable activity to false and use the max aspect ratio attribute. Of course, it's best to make your app work full screen and with multi-window, so only use this as a last resort. To make it easier to correct graphics driver issues, Android O device manufacturers may choose to update these drivers from the Play Store without having to do a system update. And of course, Android O is built on Project Treble, so devices that ship with O will be easier to update to new versions of Android in the future. Android Oreo gives users fine-grained control over notifications by adding notification channels. Apps can declare channels, which show up to users as categories. Users can block a category and alter its behavior, controlling vibration, lights, and lock screen privacy. Apps can target Android O must use channels if they use notifications. We call the notification manager to create notification channels. And then we set the notification channel ID in the compat notification builder. Android O also supports notification badging and dots by default in a channel. We can turn this off by setting set show badge to false. Android Oreo now allows apps to request adding their app widget to the launcher. You can easily check to see if app widget pinning requests are supported by the default launcher, and then have your app request them in your UI. And we've changed the way adding shortcuts works, eliminating the broadcast used in Android 7.1. Similar to app widgets, you can check to see if shortcut pinning requests are supported, and then have your app request them. Picture-in-Picture is now available for all devices, not just Android TV. To specify that your activity can use PIP mode, set Android : supports picture-in-picture to true in the manifest. All an app has to do to start picture-in-picture is call enter picture-in-picture mode from a resumed or paused state. Activities can now be launched by the app on secondary displays using activity options, simpler and easier than the presentation API. In addition, activities that support multi-window can be launched by the user on secondary displays. These displays have per-display-based configurations and resource management. This means that some parts of the configuration, such as screen width DP, screen height DP, layout, and density DP, will be set according to the display on which the activity currently resides. Fonts now are a fully supported resource type in Android O, and have also been backported to API 14 in the support library. You can use the getFont method to get a font by ID and use these fonts directly in text views. You can also define entire font families in XML, declaring the font styles and weights along with the font resource. Downloadable fonts are also supported in O and implemented in the support library. These fonts are shared between applications, making better use of storage. The 800+ Google fonts are now available directly within Android Studio, where they can either be embedded in your APK or set to download on demand. One of my favorite Android Oreo and support library features is TextView AutoSizing. You can create an array of preset text sizes or set min and max sizes with a step granularity, and the text will grow and shrink to fill the available text view space. Edit text can now be autofilled. Much of this will happen automatically, but you can help the autofill provider do a better job by giving it hints. You can also mark fields that autofill should ignore. Adaptive icon support in Oreo allows app developers to control the way their icon appears with launchers and devices that use different icon shapes, with an additional layer that can be used for animated effects. Android Studio includes a new wizard for creating adaptive icons, and O has added support for fractional inset values to make it easy to use legacy resources to build these icons. Android has a new native audio API, AAudio, designed for low-latency tasks such as effects processing and real-time synthesis. It's easier to use and adds a new direct mode that, if implemented by an OEM, allows for reduced latency. There's so much to discover in Android O, which also includes updates to media playback and recording, seeking and reversing animator sets, multi-process web view with safe browsing, strict mode enhancements, seekable file descriptors with media file access, more language support, and more. Check out the links to learn more about Android Oreo and how we're helping developers leverage key features using the support library. Also see how we're improving Android development with the launch of Kotlin support, architecture components, and Android Studio 3.0.